Blackstone Audio presents The Eighth Circle, a Danny Ryan thriller by Sarah Cain. This book is read by Ray Chase. In memory of Lily Maud, who knew all the stories.
1. We're all dying, so we might as well get on with it.
Danny Ryan looked at the words scrawled across his laptop with some satisfaction and winced. He almost felt his grandmother's bony knuckle rap against the back of his head.
Blasphemer! Do you think he died on the cross for you to dismiss life so lightly?
I'm not dismissing life. I'm saying we're all headed to one end, Danny said aloud. Then he realized how ridiculous it was to argue with a dead woman.
I spit in the face of time.
Yates again. Really?
But she was gone, and he was losing his mind by inches. He slammed the laptop shut. Danny wanted to hurl the goddamn machine across the room. What happened to the words that used to flow out of his brain through his fingers onto the keyboard? What good was a columnist who couldn't write? But he wasn't a columnist anymore. He was... what? His mind skittered through the possibilities. Dumbass, delinquent, decayed... So many D-words, but not the one he wanted. Leaning back in his leather chair, he picked up the photograph of his son that sat on his desk to the left of the laptop. Connor wore his purple soccer jersey and sported a bruise on his forehead. His huge grin showcased his missing right front tooth, and he clutched his MVP trophy in his small hands like it was the World Cup. Danny set the photograph back on the desk and forced back the surge that threatened to drown him. He opened his drawer, pulled out an old Tokarev TT-33, and then stood and walked to the stone hearth. When he sat next to Beowulf, the dog laid his massive head across Danny's knees. He stroked Beowulf's black fur. Beowulf licked his face.
This was my grandfather's.
Danny held up the gun and drew a bead on the computer. He then turned the gun around and pointed it at his temple.
The old man gave this to me, Wolf. You know why?
He pulled the trigger. The gun clicked and Danny set it on the hearth.
He said it was the perfect gun for a commie asshole.
Outside, the sound of splintering wood brought Danny to his feet. Beowulf tore into the kitchen and hurled himself at the door, barking loud enough to raise the dead. Danny left the gun on the hearth and followed. He grabbed his parka, cell phone, and a flashlight and pushed Beowulf back from the door.
Wolf, stay here.
Following the beam of light through the wind-driven sleet, he saw the hole in the fence. A car balanced precariously on the small island of ornamental shrubbery in the middle of the duck pond. Whoever sat in that car wasn't trying to get out. Rain stung Danny's face. The wind slapped his skin, and tiny pellets of ice beat against him. He called 911 and then clambered down the slippery incline. The flashlight lit up the back of the car, and Danny froze.
Jesus, he knew that old black BMW with its, I see the screw-up fairy has visited us again, bumper sticker. Michael Cohen. They'd fought. It seemed long ago now.
The wet seeped under Danny's coat, and he shoved his phone into his pocket. He heard a crunch, and the front end of the BMW dipped into the water. Danny sloshed into the pond. It wasn't that deep, but the freezing water sent shockwaves up his legs. He stumbled in the sucking mud, and the flashlight slid from his wet hand. For a moment, it illuminated the pond an eerie green and then blinked out. He grabbed the door handle with numb fingers and wrenched it open. In the glow of the overhead light, he could see the smashed windshield and Michael draped over the steering wheel. No airbags in this heap. Danny pushed Michael back as gently as he could, careful to avoid the shattered glass. Blood bubbled from Michael's nose and mouth and oozed down the front of his blue jacket. Michael gave a shuddering wheeze, and his eyes blinked open. His round face looked slack. Danny could hear the faint call of sirens now.
Don't try to talk. Help's coming.
The metallic stench of blood assaulted him.
It'll be all right, Michael.
Michael shuddered.
Danny.
Rasping coughs shook his husky frame, and flecks of bloody foam hit Danny in the face.
I love you. You know? Brothers.
Danny knew Michael didn't have much time. He leaned closer.
What happened? So sorry.
Michael's voice came slow and thick. The light in his eyes faded with each word.
Sorry? Sorry for what? Michael!
Police cars and an ambulance screeched around the curve. Red and blue lights reflected off the black water. Michael's head drooped down. When he gave a rattling wheeze, Danny grasped his shoulders.
Michael?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.